There are fears of a new international arms race after the US pulled out of a long-running treaty with Russia. America is now planning to test a missile of its own, with China issuing a warning.
It's an agreement which has stood for 32 years, but now the Nuclear Forces Treaty is on the scrap heap.
We have new nuclear coming. I hate to tell that to people, I hate to say it.
In a rare show of unity, both sides of American politics have backed President Trump's withdrawal as he and NATO accuse Russia of violating the arms pact which banned the development of intermediate-range missiles.
The new Russian missiles are nuclear-capable, mobile and hard to detect. They can reach European cities with only minutes of warning time.
The treaty was originally signed in 1987 by Ronald Reagan and Mikhail Gorbachev in a de-escalation of the Cold War. Their main concern, this, the Soviet Union's SS-20 missile.
For the first time in history, the language of arms control was replaced by arms reduction. In this case, the complete elimination of an entire class of U.S. and Soviet nuclear missiles.
Now it's been torn up, Donald Trump says the U.S. can't afford to be left behind.
They weren't living up to their commitment, and I said, if they're not going to live up to their commitment, then we have to we always have to be in the lead.
NATO countries, including Britain, backed the U.S., but China is siding with Russia, accusing America of escalating tensions.
If U.S. wishes to talk, then we will talk. If they want to fight, then we will fight.
Trump has also hit Russia with more sanctions over a nerve agent attack on former Russian spy Sergei Skripal that was carried out in Britain. But he's confident a new arms treaty can be put in place, which would also include China. Although just what it would cover is still up in the air.
But right now, we're number one, Russia's number two, and China's number three, but China's quite a bit down.
In the United States, Tim Avia, 9 News.